Hi everyone. In this video, we'll explore how to send emails using the MAILTO protocol. This protocol opens the default email client and allows users to compose a new email. While it's commonly used in web development, we'll focus on applying it in Excel to create dynamic email links. Let's break down the MAILTO syntax and explore its parameters. The basic syntax looks like this. Here, info@brainbell.com is the recipient's email address. Now, you can add parameters to customize the email further. To specify the subject of the email, use the subject parameter added after a question mark. You can also pre-fill the email body using the body parameter. You can add additional recipients with the CC parameter for carbon copy and the BCC parameter for blind carbon copy. When combining multiple parameters, separate them with an ampersand, like shown on the screen. The order of parameters doesn't matter, so you can place BCC first, body later, or arrange them as needed. Let's enter info@brainbell.com into a cell in your Excel sheet. Excel will automatically convert it into a hyperlink, which is actually a MAILTO hyperlink. Clicking the link opens your default email client and starts composing a new email with the field pre-filled with info@brainbell.com. All you need to do is enter the subject and body of the email. To pre-fill fields like the subject, body, and optionally CC and BCC, start by typing the MAILTO prefix before entering the email address. Then include all the fields you want pre-filled, such as CC, BCC, subject, and body, in the appropriate syntax. Press Enter, and Excel will automatically convert it into a hyperlink. When you click this link, your default email client will open, and a new email will be composed with the two CC, BCC, subject, and message fields already filled out. All you need to do is click the Send button, as the necessary details are pre-written. Now let's move on to a practical example. Suppose we have a list of employees, or users, or any group of people with their names and email addresses. We want to send each of them an email, and the sample email is shown on the screen. This email starts with "Hi" name of the person, like "Hi John Smith," followed by the body of the message. The email should also include proper formatting, a line break after the greeting, the message body on a new line, another line break, and the closing words such as "best" or "best regards," followed by your name. To prepare, let's first merge some cells to create space for entering your email text. This cell will be referenced in the body portion of our MAILTO formula. We won't include the "Hi" recipient name directly in this cell because it will be dynamically generated within the formula to personalize the greeting. Instead, we'll start the email text with a line break by pressing Alt-Enter, creating vertical space between "Hi" recipient name and the main body of the email. In the formula, this text will be combined as "Hi" recipient name, ensuring the greeting and the email body are seamlessly joined. Let's move to cell C2 and write a dynamic email formula using the hyperlink function. The hyperlink function is helpful because its second argument, the friendly name, lets us display user-friendly text such as "send email" to make it clear what this hyperlink is for. For the first argument, which is the link location, we start by joining the MAILTO protocol with the recipient's email address stored in cell B2. This sets the email's recipient. We use the and symbol to join different parts of text together dynamically in a formula. It acts like a glue, combining multiple text strings or cell values into one continuous string. After the MAILTO address, we add the subject parameter, subject equals quick update, to set the email subject. Next, we include the body parameter, starting with "Hi," followed by the recipient's name from cell A2, and then a comma for proper formatting. This greeting is dynamically generated for each recipient. Finally, we join the contents of the merged cell I8, which contains the main body of the email text. By using the static reference, we ensure that when the formula is copied down for all recipients in the list, it always pulls the email body from this cell. After pressing Enter, Excel creates a clickable hyperlink. Since we didn't include the second argument yet, the link displays as a long, raw hyperlink. Let's improve this by adding the second argument, "send email," to the hyperlink function. Now the cell will display a clean and user-friendly "send email" text. Clicking this link opens your email client with the two, subject, and body fields pre-filled based on the values in the formula. However, there's a small issue. The entire text appears in a single line, and the line breaks are missing. This happens because hyperlinks, including MAILTO links, follow the URL encoding standard. Certain characters like spaces, new lines, and special symbols can cause errors in URLs if they are not encoded. Encoding replaces these characters with a percent symbol followed by a two-digit hexadecimal code. For instance, a space is replaced by %20, and a new line is encoded differently depending on the context. If the text isn't properly encoded, the email client may automatically remove or misinterpret the characters it cannot process. To resolve this issue, we'll use Excel's encodeurl function. This function automatically converts text into a URL-friendly format, ensuring that special characters, including line breaks, are preserved in the subject and body parameters of our MAILTO link. After applying the encodeurl function, click the link again. You'll see that the email is now properly formatted, with new lines and spacing that make the message look professional and easy to read. Next, double-click the fill handle to copy the formula down for all recipients in the list. Now, when you click each link, you'll notice that the email message is dynamically customized for each recipient, with their name and the same well-formatted body text. Let's update our formula again to make the hyperlinks even more user-friendly. The current text, send email, looks generic and doesn't give much context, especially when working with a list of recipients. Instead, we'll personalize the clickable text to include the recipient's name, such as email to John Smith. We'll modify the formula as shown on the screen. Finally, double-click the fill handle to copy the updated formula down the entire list. Now each hyperlink is not only functional, but also descriptive, making it clear which recipient the email is intended for. These personalized links are much easier to understand and look far more professional. Thank you for watching. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell to stay updated with more Excel tips and tricks. Your support helps us create more valuable content. See you in the next video.